Lebanese riot police fired tear gas at demonstrators trying to break through a barrier to get to the parliament building in Beirut on Saturday, and shots were heard as protests over this week's devastating explosion grew. Dozens of protesters broke into the foreign ministry where they burnt a framed portrait of President Michel Aoun, a representative for many of a political class that has ruled Lebanon for decades and which they say is to blame for its deep political and economic crises. "We are staying here. We call on the Lebanese people to occupy all the ministries," a demonstrator said by megaphone. Bulldozers plowed through the wreckage of mangled homes and long rows of flattened cars as soldiers stood by. Volunteers with shovels streamed through streets. Officials have said the blast could have caused losses amounting to $15 billion. That is a bill that Lebanon cannot pay after already defaulting on a mountain of debt exceeding 150% of economic output, and with talks stalled on a lifeline from the International Monetary Fund. Mini atom bomb. France and other countries have rushed emergency aid to Lebanon, including doctors and tons of health equipment and food. The blast destroyed Lebanon's only major grain silo, and UN agencies are helping provide food and medical aid. For ordinary Lebanese, the scale of destruction is overwhelming. "It felt like a mini atomic bomb," said George Rahana, sitting beside a supermarket that was demolished. Marita Abu Javda was handing out bread and cheese to victims of the blast. "Macron offered to help and our government has not done anything. It has always been like that," she said. After Macron visited, I played the French national anthem all day in my car.